Hi, this is Mr. Wedge, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to build and alter the basic form of a house on the computer in 3D using Google SketchUp. So, first thing we're going to do is go to the Start menu in the bottom left corner, All Programs, find the Google folder. So, if you're at the top and you don't see it, it's because you need to scroll down and go to the folders. And you want the one that says Google. And the bottom one should be SketchUp. And we're going to use the internet for this. And we're going to link it with our Google Classroom account. So as soon as Google SketchUp launches, you'll see a landscape and you'll see a person standing there. That's just to show you how big other things in this world are. So we don't really need him, he's just for scale. So we'll just grab the eraser tool and erase him. And now we can start building a house. And it doesn't matter what size because we're going to 3D print these and they'll all be about the same size. So the three main tools we'll use are the pencil tool. This lets you draw lines. This is the rectangle tool and it lets you draw, you guessed it, rectangles. And the push-pull tool, which is this one right here, push-pull. So let's get started. First thing we want is a floor plan. So we'll draw a rectangle on the ground. And you can zoom in and out by rolling the middle button on your mouse, the scroll wheel it's called. So I'm scrolling up and down and it's actually zooming in and out. And if I push down on that scroll wheel, like it's a button, I get the orbit tool and I can spin around and look at it in all different directions. So you should do this a lot so that you know what you're drawing. So there's a rectangle, and basically this is like looking down on my house. So maybe this is the kitchen, this is the living room, this is a bedroom. But I don't know that yet and I don't need to. We're just doing the basic form of a house today, and next time we're going to add doors, windows, and a roof. So it doesn't have to just be a rectangle though. You can click and add other sections to your house. Maybe that'll be the garage, and this could be like a patio. And you can keep adding little things to your house. Or it could just be a rectangle if you want. So once you have some sections to it, you can start pushing and pulling. So here's the push-pull tool. And if I click it, I can just grab a surface and pull it up, and it becomes three-dimensional. So there's part of my house done. This one I'd like to be a little taller. So you notice I'm pushing down on the scroll wheel on the mouse, and I'm spinning around and looking at it from different directions. So I'll pull this up. I want this to be a little taller just to make it more interesting. And this will be a garage. So I'll make it the same, maybe not quite as tall. If everything's the same height, it's just kind of boring. But it's up to you. If you want it very simple, that's fine too. And if you want like a porch or a deck or a patio, you could just pull it up a little bit. So there we go. There's a basic house form. And if you notice, there's some lines that don't need to be there. Like there's two sections, but it's all one flat wall. So I can use the eraser tool and erase it just to simplify it. Here's another one that doesn't need to be there. I can just erase it. So the simpler this is, the easier it'll make your life in the long run. So go through and erase things that don't need to be there. There we go. If you accidentally erase a line like that, oops, clearly I did not mean to do that. As soon as you make a mistake, go down to the undo button on the left. So, right down in the bottom left above the start menu, there's an undo button, and you can just undo it. And actually, you can do that. I've done it at least 30 times, and you can keep going back, so it doesn't seem like there's ever an end to it. And if you want to redo, you can just click the forward button. So, there is a basic house form. And don't forget, erase things. If you accidentally click on a tool, and you start drawing things and you don't know how to get out of the tool, just hit the escape button on your keyboard and then you can go to the proper tool that you want to use. And oh, another thing, steps. If you want to add stairs, it's the same way. You just draw a rectangle and you push and pull. So maybe I'll put some stairs right here. So next time we'll do doors and windows and roofs. There's a basic rectangle, and you can use the line tool and split it up into different sections. And then you can push and pull. I could just grab the push-pull tool and pull these out, and now I have steps. And you could always change them. And don't forget, once you're happy with something, erase lines that don't need to be there. Oops. So I'm zooming in and out, and I'm using the orbit tool, and it's just that little wheel on your mouse that does both. So there we go. This is my basic form. I don't have doors or windows, but we'll do it next time. So as soon as you're done and you're happy with it and it looks cool, you can just go File, Save. We're going to call it our name. You don't need to type house, just call it your name. Click OK. You might have to do this twice. We want it in our classroom folder. I've got multiple folders, so make sure you click classroom. This is where you actually type the title. So you might have to do it twice. And I'm going to hit select. And this red save should turn gray and it'll say saved. And that's how you know you saved it. So that's it. Work hard. Have fun.